Well, we've just finished up week one on the SAP CodeJam Roadshow. We've done three excellent events already, and we're looking forward to doing, three more here yet this week, and then three next week as well. We've had a great event in the UK, and then two here in Germany and Stuttgart and Binheim. We're on the road now, our transition day to Hamburg, and then we'll be heading over to Amsterdam area after that. So be sure to check out the SAP CodeJam group in the SAP community if you want to see all the upcoming events. And of course, if we're not coming to an area near you, you could always put in a request for an SAP CodeJam. All the CodeJams that we're doing here were requested by community members, and they offered to host them. That's how our sites are chosen. So how has the CodeJam been for you, Rich?
Yes, let me concentrate on the road.
Well, and we're still on the road, and we hope to see many of you soon.
The latest blog post in the SAP Event Mesh series covers the integration between SAP Event Mesh and S4 HANA on-prem. The post contains step-by-step instructions on how to connect to these two technologies and outlines the benefits and various use cases for using SAP Event Mesh for S4 HANA on-prem. Be sure to check out the post linked below if you're interested in how this integration can help you, or just to play around with the tutorial. Happy coding!
Hey folks, Rich Einelman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So today I'm here in Hamburg, Germany, where I'm helping out with the CAP CodeJam with Tom and Nico. But I wanted to take a moment and let you all know about a recent blog post about how to check your custom ABAP code for ABAP Cloud. In this blog post, our friend Olga from ABAP Platform Product Management introduces us to the Cloudification Repository. So today we have the custom code migration app, which allows developers to check their custom code for cloud readiness when migrating to the SAP BTP ABAP environment. That isn't enough if you're wanting to check your custom code for ABAP Cloud in an S4HANA system. We need additional checks to ensure the use of proper S4HANA application APIs as well. So for this, the ABAP team has provided the Cloudification Repository on GitHub, which gives developers the information about the released successor APIs for ABAP Cloud development. This information found in the repository can be used as content within the ABAP test cockpit. For more information on this topic, please check out Olga's blog today.
Last week, I told you about the series of blog posts that product management is going to publish about the analytics model available now in the SAP Datasphere product. And as promised, this week, the second in the blog post series was published. It introduces an example data model that you'll use throughout the entire blog series. The post describes its structure and helps you to import the model and its data. To support the demand for data warehousing skills, SAP Education introduced two new courses, DSP01, Introduction to SAP Datasphere, and DSPBW1, SAP Datasphere, SAP BW Bridge. The second one has a strong focus on hands-on experience and provides many exercises to implement end-to-end scenarios for both a greenfield approach as well as migrations from SAP BW7 or SAP BW4HANA. Another timely offer from SAP Learning is the new free self-paced learning journey, Apply AI-powered Augmented Analytics to Business Data in SAP Analytics Cloud. After completing this learning journey, you will be able to build and deploy classification, regression, time series models, as well as analyze data using the no-code augmented analytics capabilities in SAP Analytics Cloud. As well, our developer challenge on exploratory data analysis with SAP HANA Cloud and Python continues. The week 3 challenge is released, but it is not too late to join. Personally, I'm very glad to hear your feedback that this challenge helps you learning new skills. To learn what's new in SAP HANA Cloud next release, which is coming this month, do not miss an opportunity to hear our product managers presenting and answering your questions on March 30th. Registration for this webinar is open. Last but not least, we at SAP are pleased to announce the release of the SAP Data and Analytics Advisory Methodology intended for our customers and partners. The purpose is to provide guidance in the design and validation of solution architectures for data-driven business innovations. The methodology represents an architecture approach based on the standard TOGAF architecture development method and is intended for enterprise and data architects to help execute their data strategy. The structured process is accompanied by a data domain reference model, by data and analytics capability model, and by data to value use case patterns. Links to all the content I mentioned are in the description of this video.